Hello and welcome to Positive Mental Attitude. My name is Nick, and at the end of August 2022, I had a stroke. I'm making these videos to explain my experiences of having a stroke and my recovery afterwards. Today feels like a bit of a watershed. It's a strange one. I know I say that in every episode, it's a strange one, but it is. When I got out of the hospital, which is, oh, I don't even know now, was it 8 weeks, 9 weeks ago? I had 6 weeks of physio and I had re-ablement, which is where carers come in. Didn't come in up to four times a day, but I didn't need that because I've got family who make my meals for me and will do my washing, cleaning, etc. But I did need them to come in and help me wash because I've got no left hand. Help me wash and get dressed of a morning. Now the physio stopped and I'm having to wait for another 2 months until further funded physio can start. And I've got to the point now with the re-ablement services where I feel I don't need the carers anymore. I can do it for myself. I can get up and get a wash and go upstairs and have a shower or a bath if I need to. And dress myself now. And today, I've been lucky at the carers I've had. They're all really, really nice people. Very, very easy to talk to. Highly experienced at what they do. So they're used to dealing and talking with people from all ages and all backgrounds. I found it really good in a potentially embarrassing situation to be with people that I get on well with. One of them who was here today, Rachel, it's only the second time she's come here. She's taught me a lot in those 2 times she's been here and pushed me to try and help myself more. And I've spoken to a couple of them that have been here the last week or so, that I was coming to the end of it. I was feeling like I didn't need them anymore. And today I said to Rachel, yeah, I'm gonna stop this, I don't need it. Other people need this service more than I do. I know they themselves are busy and they struggle sometimes to fit in all the calls that they need to in a day. So if I don't need them, what's the point in them coming here? I'm just taking up someone else's time. And she phoned up the office and told them that I won't need anyone anymore. So Saturday will be my last day of having care. I'm going to say it's a strange one. It's because after Saturday, there's no physio, no carer. There's no sort of connection to the hospital anymore. This is it. I am now set free. I have to do everything for myself. There's no falling back on professionals. It's just me, my family, the people around me who are helping. So it feels a weird one. Feels like, I don't know, a friend leaving, friend in school moving towns, or someone that you work with if you get on well who's got a different job somewhere else, something like that. It does feel a bit weird. Also feels a little bit, I don't want to say it's a happy feeling because it's not, but a lot of what I do, I work off milestones, and these milestones started off very, very small. In the hospital with the physio, started off with, can I sit up straight on my own without any help? That was it. That was milestone number one. And that then moved on to, can I stand up? Can I feel the ground under my feet? Can I feel the weight going through my knees as I stand up? Can I feel that? Can I feel tall again? Tick. After that, can I take a step forward, a step back? Can I keep doing that until I feel comfortable doing it? After that, can these steps be added together? So it's a little bit of like a stuttery walk. Yeah, tick. Can I then translate that into a sort of walk, which I was doing in the gym with the help of someone on that side, someone on that side, someone on a wheeled stool in front of me, making sure I wasn't getting out of position when I was walking. My left foot was stamping down like I was a counting horse. And I was Forrest Gumping all around the place. I've moved on since then where I can walk a little bit better. The mechanics are getting better because the physios have shown me how to do it. But these are all little steps. And I suppose that getting rid of the carers is another little tick. It's another milestone reached. I don't need any help. I can look after myself. Obviously, only having one working arm, it's difficult. Yesterday, my mum and dad had to change my bedding for me because I can't do it. I can do a wash and put washing into a tumble dryer. What I can't do is hang up clothes onto a clothes horse outside on the washing line. Not yet, anyway. I might get to that point where I can, but not yet. But these are still big milestones. So with them being ticked off, I should feel happy, or I should feel relieved. What I feel like is there's a sense of achievement, but also a little bit of sadness that maybe that sort of, that link between me and the hospital is now broken. And that's it now. You're on your own, lad. Get on with it. So that's what I'm doing. And also, you notice I've got a lavalier mic. So I feel like I'm about to be interviewed by Michael Parkinson. Although looking at myself there, do I look like I've just come off a narrowboat video? I do, don't I? I have to do something about that. Nothing against narrowboaters. I actually watch them videos myself, but that's a very strange look to have. Oh well, onwards and upwards. And if you are a narrowboater, happy sailing. Did he say happy sailing? Bon voyage, what did he say? Just want to leave it in the comments below because I haven't got a clue. Anyway, cheers.